different things happen in different places, God can choose to speak to you at some point or anywhere. But before you judge me, please listen to me. This is focused on our inheritance. And the same thing I'm saying to you is focused on your inheritance. The reason is because so many of us live our lives for others. The environment directs our paths. You are told when to start a school, when to get married. You are even told when to retire. So we live to fulfill the expectations of our environment, which differ from place to place. Now, that should be established in your mind. We are spirit beings living in this body as a form or channel of contact into this physical world. And as a result, our bodies are just slaves to only obey the commands of our soul, our will, where decisions are taken, our emotions, which sometimes influences the will, and our intellect, where information or experience that governs our lives are stored. It takes a developed mind, however, to be in control, but the mind cannot be developed except it is thought or formed into a shape for certain expectations. Look at Galatians chapter 4, verse 1. It says, "Now I say, as long as the heir is a child, he does not differ at all from a slave, although he is owner of everything." So also Ephesians 4:13 says, "Until we all attain to the unity of faith and the knowledge of the Son of God, to a mature mind." So the measure of the stature which belongs to the fullness of Christ. And also Hebrews chapter 5 verse 14. It says, "But solid food is for the mature, who because of practice have their senses trained to discern good and evil." Our mind is constantly subjected to the fight of conformity, as the world system will continuously fight to win you over, knowing your body only obeys the command the soul is conformed to give. Romans chapter 12 verse 2, the NIV version says, "Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will." The soul needs to be conformed to the image of Christ to obey the Spirit. For the Holy Spirit leads through our spirit, which in turn rules our circumstances through the soul. And the body carries it out while we are here. This is the same reason we will put off this mortality on our personal day by death, or the general day by rapture, as it will apply to everyone at different point, at some point in time. The reason is because we will not need this body by the time we are transferred or transformed to glory. For Christians, of course, going back to be with God, and for those that are yet or that decide not to run to Christ, then of course eternity, of course, in hell. Now, for everyone that is fully aware of who he or she is, will be conscious of an inheritance. This consciousness will guide his or her attitude and conduct. But we all sometimes get so distracted by chasing what will give us comfort, therefore moving further away from this inheritance that is all-encompassing. Everything you can ever imagine or dream or think about is in this inheritance as a child. Imagine your father leaving an inheritance for you, and you leaving that particular inheritance and chasing after all things until you come back to yourself and come back into what has been prepared for you. There are certain ways you might not be able to live or operate in. And that's one thing we all need to understand. That's why going back to God to search for what belongs to us is most important in life. Psalm 16 verse 4 to 5 says, "Their sorrows shall be multiplied, that hasten after another God. Their drink offering of blood will not offer, nor take up their names into my lips." I will not offer, nor take up their names into my lips. "The Lord is the portion of my inheritance and my cup. Thou maintainest my lot." Meaning God is who we should inherit it. We should inherit as we are here on this planet now. Now let's put it in our perception. We know Esau cried when he understood his brother Jacob had taken what by right belonged to him, even though he didn't lose the right to be called a child. Esau did not lose the right to be a child. What he lost was the right to inherit or to receive the blessing God handed to Abraham. And he knew the importance. That's why he sought for it with tears, but could not get it back. Look at Hebrews chapter 12, verse 16 to 17. It said, see to it that no one, I'm reading the BSB version, see to it that no one is sexually immoral or is godless like Esau, who for a single meal sold his birthright. For you know that afterward, when he wanted to inherit the blessing, he was rejected. He could find no ground for repentance, though he sought the blessing with tears. What he lost was the seal that guaranteed what God handed over to Abraham, and we now have access to in Christ. According to Galatians chapter 3, verse 14, he said, he redeemed us in order that the blessing given to Abraham might come to the Gentiles through Christ Jesus, so that by faith we might receive the promise of the Spirit, meaning that the Spirit is our promise. So imagine you walking in life without the Spirit of God. How do you walk into your inheritance? So many people make money, but the money comes without peace. But the point is that in the inheritance that God has given to us by the Spirit of God, the Spirit will lead you into the real truth, into understanding, into knowledge, and with peace accompanied with the blessing of God. Now, what is an inheritance? Before I go into this, sure, you want to know why I said God spoke to us in a casino. God spoke to me in a casino. I'd actually gone to pick up a check, of course, personal business and all those things. And a middle-aged man approached me and engaged me in a conversation. Why? I really do not know. But in everything we discussed, one thing stood out for me. He kept on saying, do not leave your inheritance. Do not leave your inheritance. And until I gave this thing a thought, that I realized I had recently focused more on money, of course, because of the recent commitment, which is really overwhelming. Therefore, giving little attention to my work with God, my need filled my heart every waking up day. And even in my prayer, it was all about my scary resting and the pressure coming from behind. We most, of course, times get so much caught up with our needs, which drives our desires to meet up with expectations God has already met, if only we can take up the yoke of grace. Now, look at what Matthew 11, 28-30 says, the Message Bible says about this. He said, are you tired, worn out, like I am, burned out on religions? Come to me, get away with me, and you will recover your life. I will show you how to take a real rest. Walk with me. Watch how I do it. Learn the unforced rhythm of grace. I won't lay anything heavy or ill-fitting on you. Keep company with me, and you will learn to live freely and lightly. In the Old Testament, inheritance was the gift of honor and support given by a patriarch to his son, and sometimes daughters, in the case where there is no son. It was meant for the provision and status of the family, which guaranteed the success of the next generation. This we now have through Christ, for who daily loads us with this support that we can succeed. Jesus said, my yoke is easy, my burden is light, which means you are going to notice a remarkable difference in the weight of your load the moment you submit it to him. Discover that burden, that worry, that challenge in your heart that you carry every day that destroys or spoils your countenance, that when anybody look at you, they know there's a problem with this particular young man. When you give it to Christ, you become radiant. You radiate the glory of God. And even when challenges are actually there, visible, it will not disturb or affect you, because you know you have handed it over to Christ. Just before Peter met Jesus in Luke chapter 5, verse 1 to 11, he had toiled day and night, but after he received instruction from Jesus, he caught more than his expectation doing the same business. Nobody has asked you to quit your work, business, or career. God wants us to succeed beyond our wildest imagination, but there is the right we need to obtain from him, like Jacob got from Isaac, by letting Jesus himself teach us how to do it. If you are yet to submit yourself to Christ, please run to him. For in him all the fullness of Godhead bodily dwells, and our right to prosper with peace
in him he dwells. Please say after me if you are ready. Lord Jesus, I submit all my life, desire, and my vision to you. Please take it and make me who you really want me to be. Let me never live a day without you. Save me by your blood. I confess that I am a sinner, but I found salvation in you. Use me like you used Peter, who became a fisher of men. For this, I thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. If you have said this prayer, you have just entered into your inheritance. Follow the leading of the Holy Spirit, who will lead you to a place of worship he has designed to help you in the conformity process to be like Christ. God bless you real good. My name is Udo.